This week on Wogglebox, we're invited into the lounge rooms of some real Lebanese Australian homes to watch some recent episodes of Here Come the Habibs.
Did he say hummus?
He said condoms.
Condoms? Ah, I heard hummus.
Let's see what they thought.
Meet the Habibs, Australia's...
Have you seen this?
How much did we win?
22 million.
We're billionaires?
That's a nice pool.
I want to speak to the new owner right now!
You're looking at him!
Meet Fufu.
Fufu, that's... I think I've eaten that before.
I don't even think he's led that guy.
And you never hear Fufu in the whole entire Arab world.
I kind of wish they didn't, like, clip the middle bit of his, like, and just left the monobrow. In Lebanon, they won't clip the middle bit. It's like a McDonald's sign.
And Layla.
I swear to God, it's Joey.
Swear to God.
Is she actually Lebanese?
No. Apparently she's Colombian.
Too thick.
Subwoofer pens.
This guy does my head in.
Hey, now remember, you're my entourage.
Look how he speaks all the time.
Here come the Habibs.
The neighbors from hell.
And there goes the neighborhood.
The writer should be a Lebanese and Australian origin.
Habib.
Here they come. Here they come.
I love how gangster they make everything. Like, if it's got to do with, like, somebody remotely Middle Eastern or from Western Sydney, it's got to be all gangster.
New personal best from the airport.
And this one is playing the shish kebab guy in the taxi. That's too much.
What is it called? Taxi
kebab? But with kebab. Yeah, but that's too much stretch to the extreme.
Mustafa, good driver.
Yeah, and that's with excess baggage.
Baggage, bro.
Baggage, bro.
Do you see any taxi with the shish kebab in it?
It's an idea.
I don't like it.
One of them called me a wog once. You know what my reaction was?
What?
I said, you're an Australian by force. I'm an Australian by choice.
But even then, like, eastern suburbs, you walk down the street as somebody who might not be white, and honestly, they won't look at you twice. No, the amount of times I'd say hello to people that I walk past and nobody, like, just put their head down.
They're scared of you, firstly.
That's it, why. Yeah.
What's that in the background?
We're all in for a little camp kitchen and facilities.
I'm sure it brings back fond memories of a grotty village youth.
What the f***? Village youth?
We could have a campfire sing-along.
Kumbaya yalla yalla really isn't my thing.
Oh, that's so cringe.
I got no idea what they're talking about.
We're all, you know, backward village folk, shitting in the ground, just f***.
Go back to where you came from.
Go back to where you come from.
They used to call us wogs and whatever.
I've never been told that.
I was born in Campbelltown.
So you wouldn't want to go back to it? Oh.
You got any good neighbours?
At the moment, no.
This show is what white people think.
Are you sleepy?
I think the thing is, if you're watching something like this, you've got to take that. It's going to be exaggerated.
I understand that they're trying to play on stereotypes, but it's just, it's not working.
This show is very boring. I don't like it at all.
I recommend that they bring a Lebanese origin writer to really write the exact what the Lebanese culture and Australian culture put together.
Bye. Zero, Celine, don't watch it.
I don't think it resonates with me or your family.
Mum,
I don't like it.
Your mom.
On next week's episode, new lounge rooms, new homes, as we show Jonah from Tonga to Islanders. It's Fobblebox.